So some classics, almost all of them, have mentioned timing of events. And we want to know the timing, like how they have timed the event. Like some rishi will say, if so and so combination is there, marriage will happen at the age of 16. If so and so combination is there, marriage will happen at the age of 14, etc. And people have tried to decode it. Some people have tried to decode it with the use of transit. Some people have used something hypothetical, such as progression, that is now mainly used in Nadi. We traditional people try to decode it using Sudarshan Chakra. Sudarshan Chakra is the technique we discussed in the first class. First house, first year, first house, 13th year, first house, 25th year, etc. Right? And this is what we discussed there. Good. Though I have given you a, I have given you many researches of mine regarding the Sudarshan Chakra. I'm short of words on how to put it. That's the only thing, because I just want to take some time to explain it. Otherwise, I can just tell you today's technique and end the class in 20 minutes. That I actually don't want. But just give me a second. Yeah. So I have given you a better working formula according to my method that I think works better than, because when Parashar have mentioned about Sudarshan Chakra, he doesn't mention about these things that I have told you. Now these things are my researches, but of course you cannot do a baseless research at the end of the day. There have to be some base behind it. My only strength in astrology is my understanding of shlokas. That's all. So I understand it in a better way, or what the God knows it. It is something which I cannot explain. It is a type of a gift. You know, when I read a shloka, something bangs my head that why it is this particular way. Why there is, you know, why it is not in another way. However, leaving that aside. So in many classics, as I have told you, ages are mentioned. That if so and so combination is there, so and so thing will happen at this point of time. This is mentioned. But is it direct? If sun is situated in the 11th house, one will get vehicle at the age of 24. Is it direct? 11th house comes at the age of 23 instead, not 24, by the way. So why vehicle at the age of 24? Maybe we will want to explain it like it will happen in 23, 24. Or if one gets a loan, at least 1 year will take an approval. Either way. According to my understanding, what I have understood over the time is talking of the Sudarshan Chakra, or rather activation of something. And this is fairly applicable to Sudarshan Chakra, and it is fairly applicable to Dashas also, if you have the understanding to use it. So I'll give you just four or five small stuff is what I will want to talk about. Just a second. Yeah. So this can be used in Dasha, this can be used in transit, this can be used with Sudarshan Chakra, this can be fairly used with any technique. Just you have to know how to use it, and it is very brilliant, right? I don't have to super emphasize this particular fact. So how it works, I will just tell you. Now suppose there's a particular combination. I will come to it in two. I just have to explain this particular thing, then I will directly come to the third technique for coach. So first of all, let's talk about it. Suppose there is a particular combination happening in a house. When will that get activated? I will give you a small demo illustrating all the four techniques that I have found regarding this. Suppose this is a Libra Lagna. Okay, I will make a Libra Lagna chart. And will tell you how it will work. Yep. Okay. Let me fill the planets in the chart. And all the nine planets in the chart. Now the activation. I will use the word activation. Okay, I will use the word activation. This activation you can use with dasha, antardasha, you can use with transit, you can use with Sudarshan chakra, whatever technique you want to use it with. This is something universal, is what I have found, right? This is the way how sages are like trying to predict. The common understanding, which is faulty, is that Ketu is in Lagna. So when Lagna is activated, the result of Ketu is activated. I think the basics of people are so bad. The basics of people are so bad that they cannot distinguish between things. Suppose in this particular chart, sixth house is activated and the person is having a problem related to boils and pimples. Suppose. People will say sixth house is activated. That's the reason person is having boils and pimples. It is a shitty, useless logic. Boils and pimples are caused by Mars. There is no Mars in the sixth house. There is no connection of Mars with the sixth house. How can Mars do it? This problem makes you a bad astrologer. Okay, sixth house indicates disease. That is very fine. But when any house is activated, anything that is happening, that also have to be connected to the planet influencing that house either by position or by aspect or the lord. So never fall into this particular trap. Sixth house activated, it will give any disease in the world. No. Of course not. Right? This is something that we have to understand. Basics have to be extremely clear. You cannot mess with it. You know, this problem happens. People, you know, this is the reason people can't predict. This is the major reason. Because we don't know which signification will get activated at what point of time. We don't know. We see the activation of the sixth house and we are like, okay, this disease happened because of sixth house. The dasha will change and the problem will go. Dasha change, the problem is still there. Because it is not because of the sixth house. That's the pretty problem. Are you getting my point? Yes. For this chart, you know, an astrologer told you have Saturn in the second house. Saturn indicates disease. You will have diseases of the throat. It never happened. The disease is because of Mars aspecting Saturn. It is the mutual aspect of two inimical powers. That is causing the result. But until and unless you find this funda, neither you can predict the disease correctly, neither you can predict the start. Nothing you can do. So that is the first basic thing that have to be pretty clear. When what thing have to happen? What type of child is indicated from the fifth house? What child of indicated? What type of child is indicated from the ninth house? That have to be pretty clear if you want to be very good at predictions. Otherwise, this will become a problem. However, that's not my topic. So Ketu is in Lagna. When Lagna will be activated, Ketu will get activated. Is the basic understanding that we have, right? Sadly, Lagna getting activated and this Lagna activating the traits of Ketu is only 15% possible. Not more than that. Let me be very honest with you. Rule number one that you should take from me. Is that before looking at planetary placement, give more importance to aspect. And mind my work. Before taking the planet in the Rashi, take aspect. Always. Aspect is more powerful than the placement itself. There's no doubt about it. If you doubt my word, check the mental life of a person having malefic in the seventh house versus mental life of a person having malefic aspecting the seventh house, and you will know the difference. Versus take a person having malefic in the seventh house, but that seventh house getting aspected by only malefic planets, you will know. And you will be banging your head on the wall that he is having malefic in the seventh house, but why he is having a good marriage. This malefic influencing the seventh house can be the seventh lord itself, doesn't matter. It will still destroy the marriage. There's no doubt about it. So aspect is 100 times, 1000 times more powerful than a placement is the first thing that you have to keep in mind, and there should be no doubt about it. So first of all, whenever you see the activation of a house, firstly, give preference to the aspect over the house. Rather than the planet situated there, aspect will work. Because aspect indicates the karma, kriyaman karma. Aspects 80% of the time indicates the kriyaman karma. You know, there is a planet in the seventh house and that planet indicates a trait. And you will see many people who don't indulge with that trait. Whereas if a planet is aspecting the seventh house, the trait of that planet will be in the matter life. It is unavoidable. You cannot change it. So the aspect is something you cannot escape. Placements 80% of the time people escape. Those who with a strong will, you will see planet placed in different houses for them doesn't work. But aspect is that something that cannot be escaped. Aspect will happen for sure. So the first thing is give preference to aspect. Sorry for my pathetic handwriting. I am very bad at writing with my mouse. Okay, the second rule, if the planet in the house the result of the planet will happen when the exaltation sign, debilitation sign or the own sign of planet is activated. I will repeat it. The event of a planet will happen when the Rashi, where the planet gets exalted, where the Rashi, where the planet gets debilitated, or the own Rashi of the planet is activated. For an example, in this chart, you see Sun in the sixth house. Do you think that the disease will come with the activation of the sixth house? No. The disease will come with the activation of the seventh house, with the activation of the Lagna, and with the activation of the 11th house. Because seventh house is the exaltation of Sun, Lagna is the debilitation of Sun, and 11th house is the own sign of Sun. That is another funda that you should always remember. Getting my point? Good. You take marriage of people and check the Shantra Dasha. and answer me how many times it is the dasha antar dasha of the planet who is either exalted or debilitated in the Rashi. And not the house lord or the planet in the house. Ma'am, questions at that.
Okay, sir.
Right. So this is the second thing. The third topic, the third point basically, if there is a planet conjoined, I'll repeat the word. If there is a planet conjoined, then this exaltation, debilitation of own sign. If a planet is conjoined with the planet, then this exaltation, debilitation or own sign of the one stronger will work. As an example, there is Sun in the sixth house conjoined with an exalted Venus and a debilitated Mercury. And out of them, Venus is the most powerful one. So the result of Venus, Sun and Mercury in the sixth house will actually get activated. When the Lagna is activated, own sign of Venus. Eighth house is activated, own sign of Venus. Sixth house is activated, exaltation of Venus. Or 12th house is activated, debilitation of Venus. So that is another thing you have to remember. The rule number 4 and the rule number 5 also. The rule number 4 is the house. Sometimes it can also happen that a planet is situated in Lagna, and when Lagna got activated, the result of the planet started fructifying. That can only happen when the planet is in that house with either the Karaka or having any connection with the house lord. For an example, you will see Jupiter in the fourth house. The result of this Jupiter will be activated with the activation of the fourth house itself. Why? Because it is under the aspect of the house lord. When the planet is having any relationship with the Rashi lord or house lord, whatever you say, or when the planet is connected with Karaka, in that scenario, only in that scenario, the result will be fructifying when that house comes to activity. That is pretty important. Don't forget. And rule number 5, if none of them works 80% of the time, the result will happen when the 5 and 9th to the Rashi is activated. The result of this Mars will happen when the 11th house and the 3rd house is activated, the 5 and 9 to the planet. Right? These are the 5 rules that should be kept into consideration always. Never forget it. You try using this principle with Dasha and you will be stunned with the result. I can guarantee you regarding this. There's no doubt about it. Regarding Dasha, in this exaltation, debilitation, own sign, etc., you can take either the Lord of the Rashi, Lord of the exaltation sign, Lord of the debilitation sign, Lord of the own sign with the planet itself. Or you can also take the planet situated there if there is any planet situated. Getting my point? It is extremely clear. There's no confusion about it. Good. Okay. All right. This thing is fairly understood.